All right, well, I'm Luke, and I'm going to show you guys how to set up a plate for your urea experiment. So something that's kind of recommended is for just the top two rows. So you have A through H, and then 1 through 12. A and B are generally just going to be a blank buffer. C through E, how I'm going to be setting it up today, is going to be our wild-type protein. And then F through H is going to be our respective mutant. So we have 10 different concentrations of urea, so I'm going to go 10 across. And then this is a multi-channel pipette. So the way a multi-channel pipette works is very similar to a normal pipette. You just push it down, release it, and then it'll suck up the liquid. And then you can again push it all the way down in order to release all of your remaining liquid. So since I'm going to be having 10 different samples, I'm going to just max this guy out and go with 8. So then you have these nice little wells here. So I'm going to be putting my buffer in first. So what you can do is you can just pour it into these guys right here, which have a nice little valley, so you can get all of the liquid out. And then, like I said, it's just a normal, like a normal pipette. So you're going to push it down and put all the tips in and suck it up so you can see.
Yeah, and at this point, it's really good to take a look and make sure that the level of liquid is the same each of the tips. So sometimes one of the tips just doesn't get on there all the way, and then it won't hold the liquid, and then you'll have a weird volume in that row. So these all look fine, so good.
Yep, just go across to the 8.
See, so there was a bad one. It's fine, you can just do one more.
Yeah, so then I'm going to need 3 over there. And then just 2 for this last one. And then I'm just going to be doing the exact same thing for my other samples.
And you don't have to use a different of these each time. You can just kind of, actually the liquid pours out pretty well. And you can kind of wipe it out with a Kim wipe or rinse it with water if you think you need to. And as we are doing, we should try to find a way to make use of everyone.
It's a team effort.
Yes.
Designated two-bit launcher. So yeah, that's one time where this little guy didn't get as much liquid, so you want to just push it back out, then slide it back up, so this one must not be on there. Okay.
Alright, so then at this point you would use the multi-channel again and do the same thing to add each concentration of urea. So these are 1.5 mil stocks, which is enough to fill the center of these little well things. All right, so I have the first urea solution in here, and he's gonna do the same thing.
Just making sure it's all the tips are on all the way. So you gotta push down kind of hard, but not too hard. And then just the same thing, except we're going to be going in columns now with the urea samples.
So. Exactly the same all the way across the plate. And once you're done, you just have to tap it a little bit to mix it, and then you're ready to go.
You want to shake in a T formation since it's circular.
Helpful. Thank you.